Sorry guys, I had to. I had all those parts laying out there, and it just reminded me of the movie, so I'm like, alright, make this little video here. Anyways, I got some parts in, and I think we got enough to try and kind of start putting the motor back together. Jake's going to swing by after work and help me degree this cam in, but here's what we got here. Alright guys, so you know in my last video I said I was looking at a Lunati camshaft. Well, it turns out they canceled my order because it was out of stock. Cam grinds are really far behind right now, it seems like, everywhere I looked. But, so, if you remember, I had an F303 camshaft in it. That's only 412 degrees of lift. The Lunati I was looking at was a jump up to 565, but they were out of stock, so I ended up buying this camshaft. They have them in stock, and it's just the old, it's still kind of old school, but it's an Anderson's Motorsport cam. This is the B451, and here's the lift. So the lift on it with 1.6 rockers is 576 on intake and exhaust, 112 degrees of lobe separation. This is like their biggest hydraulic roller that they make, which is actually bigger than the Lunati. So in hindsight, this is probably better suited for this motor, you know. It's kind of hard to find big hydraulic roller camshafts for a small block Ford. This isn't no LS, so we don't got the luxury of just cams everywhere, so. But I've on some old school forums, some old turbo bullet, yellow bullet, some guys were saying that they have gone pretty fast with this camshaft. I've seen guys, they were clicking 530s or quicker with this. So this should be more than capable. It's a lot bigger than an F cam. So yeah, we'll get this wiped down, get it put in. I got my timing gear set and everything, so yeah. All right, here's a little POV shot of camshaft going in. As you can tell, I just oiled it up just a little bit. You don't really got to grease them up heavy like you would a flat tap at camshaft. This is roller, so it doesn't really matter. Just so it's got a little lube on there so it's not dry in the bearings. I have to grab a screwdriver. I don't know if they make a tool for this or not, but I just put it in there so you can kind of pick up on the cam. Come on, get in there. Right like that. She's in. Okay, I've got one of these little, this is the cam retainer, and this is a little upgraded piece. It's actually roller bearinged. On a stock one of these, this is just a metal retainer plate. This one actually has a little roller bearing in it to help reduce drag. A little cheap little upgrade. Make sure oil galley here goes to the oil spot, obviously. Because I'm pretty sure you can flip them around. I'll get that torqued down. Okay guys, looking at this Lunati timing gear set, this is pretty nice. I haven't seen one of these before. Is if you look at the back side of the cam gear, it has a roller bearing on it, which I've never seen before. Yeah, I've never seen one. It's usually just solid metal and it just rides against, you know, this plate, which you can kind of see where the old one was riding. This has got a rollerized bearing on it to even further reduce drag on that, so that's pretty sweet.
Well, guys, it is the next few days. As you can see, I got the car mostly done. So I'll show you what we got here.
All right, motor is back in, as you can see. I got the cam all degreed in. It's perfect. I was going to show it, but then I was like, well, we don't want to give away too many secrets on this thing. But here's the turbo mounted up to my existing turbo kit. Oh, looks good. I have to make a different downpipe because this is a little bit longer than the 400 series Borgs. No big deal, really, but yeah, this is just be quick. As you can see, we got something missing here. So, yeah, if you guys didn't realize already, I'm big into, like, OG Ford stuff from, like, Go Fast parts from the 80s and 90s, like the original really cool muscles and Mustangs, Fast Forward, 5.0 magazine type stuff. Real vintage shit. Hard to get stuff. So yeah, stay tuned. We got something really cool coming for this. They're very rare, and it's a sweet piece. I also got my little 2.3 turbo sold, which I know there's not much of a following on this, but if you know anything about 2.3 turbos, this was a bad unit right here. Aluminum headed, all ported, Esslinger built. Once again, this is kind of one of those like 80s, 90s pieces of gold. So, yeah, stay tuned, guys. I'll make a video specifically on this piece that's coming in for this. It'll be really sweet. Subscribe, and thanks for watching.